What's up, guys? It's your boy Demone, aka Demonevational, and welcome to another video. Today, we're going to give you guys an update on the Lapis Challenge account, well, the SWC Challenge account now, with progress. We are pulling close to day 120, the 4-month mark for this account that I started on October 5th. So, if you guys have been following along this account, watching the progress, I wanted to kind of give you guys an update as to what's been going on. I've had some more unique pulls, like the Light Anubis here, who I've been kind of playing with, Chilling, Triton. Chiwu, I think, is new, and also a few Sig. But more importantly, although I've been pulling like a lot of stuff like Stella, Water Kung Fu Girl, and stuff, I don't really have any intentions of using them just yet, just because that's just not what I'm focused on. My primary focus right now is my runes and making sure that my teams are scored away. As you guys know, in the last... let me give you guys a tower update, too. In terms of tower update, what I'm doing right now is, my towers are my crit damage tower is max, speed totem is still zero, attack tower is level 4, my wind attack tower is almost max, which we will upgrade this right now. Boop. Aw, man, it took me out of the, alright. And water attack tower is level 1 just because I was raging because my Alicia couldn't clear waves in arena, and I just kind of like rage bought that just out of like impulse. But yeah, we're just continuing to move forward. Like I said, guys, the primary focus right now is ensuring that my my GB10 team is squared away. So what the team that I've been running as of late has been this team. Okay, this team here is just my safer comp. It wipes a hell of a lot less, whereas this team is what I got my 38 second GB10 run with. Where are you at, Charlotte? Charlotte. Okay, this is the team that I used in order to get my 38 second run. And honestly, guys, like, I had no idea that speed tuning was so important. So I went ahead and all the farming that I've been doing, like in getting the runes and stuff like that, fortunately I had the runes to speed tune my team. And I'm going to talk a little bit about that too and the adjustments. Before I get into that though, I did do a test run, Dragons with Verde Hill. Where's Verde? I used Verde. Matter of fact, let me just go to Dragons so you guys can see the team. This is the team that I tested in Dragons. We hit 59 seconds with this team comp, in Dragons. And again, I've done this without, like, these guys are all on Giants runes, minus Lin, who I was fortunate enough to craft some Vile runes, and I've got some lucky pulls out of the shop, that I bought. Well, specifically this rune, this rune I got out of the shop. The rest of the Vile runes are crafted, and then we just roll those. And then, so we were able to get Lin's damage to where she's at. She recently got speed tuned, just because, like, using her on Giants and making sure she's going in the correct order. I was using her here, and with this team comp, I got 59 seconds, and my Tark's damage is nowhere near where it needs to be. We're at 91, 165 here with plus 105 speed. I want to get this attack power way up and this crit damage closer to 200%, okay? But yeah, like Swift Energy here. My other one, he was on Fatal. He doesn't have a rune here because I moved this rune after I hit the 59 second run. I moved it over to, who did I move it to? One of my Lucians to get them speed tuned for Giants so I can speed up my Giants run. So I'll replace that rune here soon. And then my Vertahill also had 3 Fatal runes here, or a Blade rune and a Fatal rune that I also moved to other units. Just because, again, speed tuning my Lucians and getting my Lucian square so I can hit that 30 second Giants. Okay, so that has changed. Before though, he was at 90 plus 101 speed, 100% crit rate, and then that's pretty much it. I mean, nothing else to mention. I mean, he's only level 7. I mean, you know, but he was level 7 at the time when we did this. We had 59 seconds on Dragons. Again, how I did it, we hit it, and I realized, like, watching the run, like, I need more damage. Otherwise, it won't be consistent. But we did it, full clear, no revives, awesome, okay? So, that's that, and I did it without the speed tower. Boom, let's go. So that's cool. So I'm continually leveling my towers. I want to maximize my damage first since I got a place. What I'm going to continue to do is increase the speed of my units slowly but surely. I really want to see how far I can push the envelope without the speed tower to see just exactly when you need it. And when it plays a major role. I can say that if I had the speed tower, it would make things like easier, right? Because I could use it as a crutch, for instance. Like I would need 10 speed less on each of these units, and the rune quality wouldn't really need to be there, essentially. And then I could just cheese it. But again, I want to see at what position is the speed tower absolutely, utterly, and totally important to progression. Because so far, like from just testing it, like it's I don't know, it's not really. I haven't really ran into a speed issue until I got into speed comps, and where I noticed that my speed tuning was way off. Then of course arena. Okay, TOA has been fine because you can cheat TOA. You can just use an attack bar booster. Kind of the same thing with arena. Not really. I mean, kind of with arena, but I'm talking like on a whole different speed level. Like when your units are all 200 plus speed, and then now you're using a 300 Bernard, then you're still kind of cheating the attack bar. But that's a conversation for a completely different day. But looking at the units, the adjustments that I did make, because if you guys watched my video, my Giants 10 team sucks, or Speed GB 10 team sucks. This is when I was back pushing close to 1 minute. So what I went ahead and did is I adjusted. This is when I started using the Rune Optimizer, and I went ahead and adjusted all my Lucian speed. So this Lucian is 143. Lin is also 143, and I want to talk to you guys about team positioning here. And then this Lucian's 147. So I got my strongest Lucian here with the wave clear at 86/185. And then I got my second strongest Lucian going afterwards. So this one is pretty much guaranteed to clear a wave. This is my Galleon here. If you guys are wondering why my Galleon is so fast, it's because initially when I plugged Galleon into my team comp, he wasn't scaled up at all, and I was running a lot of attack bar reduction. So, Lupinus, ATB reduction on 3, Charlotte ATB reduction on 3, and Hua. So, like, I wanted to just speed him up so he can get as many turns as possible. So even if he derped, I mean, he had to land at some time was my mentality, right? But I kind of just left him at the speed that he's at. And then we just work around it, right? Because I'm not going to go farm dragons to get a vial set for him. So he's just going to have to be what it is right now, okay? So that's what's going on with that. And then in terms of these are my damage here. And then for my 38 second run, which is my new record on Giants right now. I use Charlotte, so Lucian, Lin, Charlotte, Galleon was my team. However, the Charlotte is not consistent enough yet because my damage output just isn't there. Once I get the two Lucians and Lin basically taking half the boss's HP, it'll get a lot more consistent. I'm going to be doing another video where I'm going to be talking about the processes of speed tuning now that I'm starting to break my own records. Like my fastest dragon's time now is 59 seconds, which before it was only like a minute 23, right? And that was on my old account. Now we're down to 59 seconds. We're going to continue to push that. Again, dragons is not the focus just yet, but I did wanted to do some dry runs to see, and we hit 59 seconds, so that's good. And then we'll continue to push that envelope. And then speed comp, speed. So one thing that I did run into, guys, working on this account, is that my Lucian and my second Lucian at 143 and my Lin at 143 as well, I ran into an issue where they were going out of order. Now the beautiful thing about not having a speed tower, now again, and I'm never recommending not having a speed tower in game late game, because it's absolutely important at that stage in the game. But one thing that I stumbled upon not having a speed tower is because these two units are the same speed, depending on where I place them in the team composition will determine the turn order. So like if I put Lin here before Lucian, Lin will always go before Lucian. If I put Lin here and then Lucian is here, then this Lucian will always go before Lin. Because if all of your units are the same speed, without the speed tower of course, because then it plays off the particular unit's base speed, then it goes from left to right. So, the lead is first, then Galleon, then Hua, then Lucian, then Lin. Okay, so that's a little trick you guys can kind of use if you guys don't have any level ups in the speed tower, or if you have two units with the same base speed and your speed and you do have a speed tower and they're exactly the same speed and you're trying to optimize their turn order. Okay, so that's that. What else? that's pretty much it. I haven't been pushing an arena at all since we tried to hit that you know, that plunge before. I just wanted to see where I was at. Now I know that I just need to fine tune. What I'm working on right now is getting my Lucians since I pulled the second one. It kind of changed my goals a little bit here. So what you guys are going to start to see is these Lucian speeds start to go steadily up and up and up while still maintaining the same stats. So like I still want to do 86% crit, 200% crit damage, but the speed is going to go to 200. The goal being around 2 to 215-ish. So we're going to continue to do that and work that out, keep the attack power the same, and just keep pushing and pushing and pushing and pushing so I can get my double Lucian comp for arena ready as I continue to farm giants. And now that I know that my dragons team just needs a couple of tweaks in terms of damage output, and just getting my team well cogged, and then we can beat the 59 second time and maybe go for a 45 second run once we get the damage output and of course get the consistency, things are pretty much on a straight course as of right now, and we're going to continue to drive and push and push and push and farm and farm and farm and farm and farm and farm, and get our squads where they need to be. How I'm looking at it now is I'm just going to farm giants until I'm excited about my runes. Then we're going to do kind of a short stint, not really a short stint, probably about 3 months each, Dragon's Necro, maybe, depending, I don't know, this is just guesstimating, and then the finishing touches will be in R5. After I get my runes to wear, I'm like, okay, listen, I'm going to have to farm for a year to improve these runes, then it's like R5 time, then we'll hit grinds, and then we'll finish up all the meanwhile while, starting to get into RTA and play with PvP. At this point, I expect to obviously be Guardian 3, but... Again, this is just rune improvements over time, maxing my towers, you know, and all the little stuff in between. And like I said, every couple of weeks or so, I'll give you guys an update because now we're starting to take big strides. Now that we had 38 seconds in Giants, 59 seconds in Dragons, the real journey is starting to begin, and we're getting closer to our mark. My biggest dungeon day, most runs day, was 700 runs. That was just because I was farming elemental dungeons. Those were super fast elemental runs. But consistently, we're getting close to the 500 run average right now. And this is without the speed adjustments that I just made. So I'm going to keep tracking on Swap Farm to see where I'm at. But again, the goal being 1,000 runs a day. And we're pulling closer and closer and closer to that as we continue. And it's crazy. Okay, it's absolutely crazy. So again, guys, I just wanted to take a little bit of time, give you guys a brief update, let you guys know what's going on. I'm going to go back to Giants now and do my thing. So with that being said, guys, thank you guys so much for tuning in. As always, it's your boy Demone, aka Demonevational on Twitch, and we'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.